Hello, I'm Urologist Ömür Erdem Akkaya. In today's presentation, I would like to discuss the topic of Trenbolone and its detrimental effects. The reason for my interest in this topic is due to the unique nature of Trenbolone as an anabolic steroid. Unlike other anabolic substances, Trenbolone poses a significant threat to the environment as it can infiltrate the metabolism of plants, animals, and dairy products. This can lead to a variety of health problems and discomfort for these organisms. Despite these dangers, Trenbolone remains a popular substance among anabolic steroid users due to its highly effective and functional properties. It belongs to the nandrolone group, a collection of compounds that includes DECA. The key distinguishing feature of this group is its inability to aromatize into estrogen or convert to dihydrotestosterone. Trenbolone was first produced in France during the 1970s and was initially used for human consumption. However, it was quickly removed from use due to concerns regarding its safety. Injectable forms of the substance were later made available for use in animals. The manufacturing of injectable forms of Trenbolone was discontinued due to the large quantities being smuggled into America for bodybuilding purposes. Instead, the substance was commonly produced in pellet or implant forms, which contained 150 to 200 milligrams of Trenbolone and were designed to be implanted under the skin of animals' ears. Over a period of 40 to 50 days, these pellets would release the Trenbolone into the animal's body at a slow and steady pace. The use of Trenbolone in animals has been shown to increase muscle mass by 10 to 15% and decrease the amount of fat in muscle tissue by 5 to 10%. As a result, it is considered a profitable molecule that can increase the efficiency of animal production. However, there is ongoing controversy in America regarding the potential harmful effects of Trenbolone on both human health and the environment. There are hundreds of studies on this in PubMed. While cattlemen argue that the use of Trenbolone is not harmful, many scientists argue that it is, or at the very least, has the potential to be harmful. In Turkey, the use of anabolic substances on animals is illegal, including Trenbolone. Trenbolone is a powerful steroid that has both androgenic and anabolic effects on the body. Its anabolic effects are much stronger than those of testosterone, with about 3 times the potency. When ingested, Trenbolone strongly stimulates muscle growth and fat burning, making it a popular substance among bodybuilders and athletes. Despite not aromatizing into estrogen, Trenbolone can cause gynecomastia or the development of breast tissue in males. This is because 17-beta-trenbolone strongly stimulates progesterone receptors in the body. Additionally, Trenbolone can significantly increase the amount of oxytocin in the blood, which is an interesting side effect of the steroid. What is oxytocin? Oxytocin is a hormone that causes milk secretion by expanding the ducts in the nipple after birth in women. At the same time, oxytocin is a powerful libido enhancer and sexual enhancer. In those who use Trenbolone, there is an increase in libido and sexual power. It can reduce the amount of thyroxine T3. It increases the amount of IGF-1, insulin-like growth factor 1. It also makes the tissue receptors of IGF-1 more sensitive. Again, there are many studies on this. It does not increase growth hormone. It says that it doesn't increase it in the publications I read. This makes sense because it increases IGF-1. This suppresses the growth hormone. It affects many hormones in the body. It has typical side effects: coughing, dark urine color, and irritability. In addition, when the drug is quitted, the user may experience difficulties in sex drive, sexual power, and erection. Because it's a very powerful medicine, the stronger the effect of a drug, the more side effects it can have. It suppresses endogenous testosterone very strongly, much more strongly than testosterone. Those who use it then need to have a PCT. Trenbolone has another unique harm, though. I saw this in another video on YouTube. I also evaluated the publication on that subject in detail. In Alzheimer's disease, a substance called beta-amyloid accumulates in the brain. As this substance accumulates and increases, plaques begin to form and these plaques destroy the brain. The patient can't know where he is, who he is, his daughter or son, and when he leaves the house, he can't return home, because he can't find his house. 17-beta-trenbolone increases the substance called beta-amyloid in the brain. They've shown this in animal studies. But the interesting thing is, this rate did not increase in animals that took Trenbolone with testosterone. This is thought to be the reason why sex hormones, estrogen, testosterone, and dihydrotestosterone have protective properties for brain functions and are also thought to be protective against Alzheimer's disease. Trenbolone has this unique feature as a side effect. At the same time, when we look at the stories of the cases of acute pancreatitis and acute cholecystitis who were hospitalized after using anabolics, we see that trenbolone is definitely included in their cures. Because it is a very effective drug. As I said, you need to be very careful. There are many publications that show that this still affects the reproductive functions of fish and the reproductive functions of plants in the world. Because of course, animals consume this the most. Animals consume this in America. Trenbolone implants are given to thousands to tens of thousands of animals at the same time, and these implants expel 17 beta trenbolone from the animal's body, and 17 beta trenbolone remains in nature for a long time. It does not dissolve in nature and creates environmental pollution. Discussions about this still continue. People do not want to consume meat products containing trenbolone. They think there may be some problems. People don't even want to consume its meat, but for bodybuilding. There are those who apply weekly trenbolone starting from 150 mg in cycles up to 700 mg or 1000 mg. Of course, we should respect their decisions, but their harm must be known. It is also necessary to know what is what. Thank you for listening, with all respect.